Oh, do you like this? Do you like this? Do you let it down for you, touch you, put you like this? Matter of fact, never mind, we gon' let the past be. Maybe his right now, but your body still
I don't wanna know.
Sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water and I think of all the things what you're doing and in my head I paint a picture. Well, since I come home, well, my body's been a mess and I miss your gentle hip and the way you like to dance. So come on over, stop making a fool out of me. Oh, why don't you come on over, Valerie?
Necessarily haven't came up with a show name yet today, but it'll be maybe randomness of random.
pretty good.
I like that.
Yeah, definitely.
It's good.
This is my philosophy of doing shows. It keeps randomly changing each and every time. It's never the same one.
That's
it good. Keeps everything fresh.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's the first and last time this will actually happen.
That's too much. That's wild. That's crazy.
It's mind blowing.
Yeah,
it's. But we're good. Here for a beautiful night.
Yeah.
At, you know, the beautiful studios of Lake Effect Radio in Kirtland, Ohio, and we're here with Chill.
Hey.
Hello.
What have you guys been up to? You've been staying out of trouble.
Yeah, I mean, it's been pretty good. We're getting ready for our 10-year anniversary show. On Sunday, getting ready to announce some summer shows as well too, and just generally staying busy doing the thing,
having fun the whole time.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Doing a thing and a thing.
Yeah, no, it's just lots of stuff all the time.
I feel it.
Yeah.
But one thing in that, since I know it's 10 years in it, did you ever think you would be still going?
Yeah.
After 10 years.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's actually kind of funny, like. One of the things too is like we never even thought about it. Like, 10 years just wasn't even like, oh, it's gonna like end at some point. It was just kind of always something that we like did. You know what I mean?
Nah, man. Yeah. I was thinking long term way back when I was a wee little kid.
Yeah.
Gonna go be a rock star.
Yeah.
Yeah, a rock star in 30 years.
Yeah, exactly. You're gonna be like Neil Peart, just like 70 and. Super
yeah.
Ball.
Yeah.
It's surreal.
It's surreal. And it's out there now, folks. You heard it here first. Yeah.
So in 30 years,
yeah.
Exactly.
We'll have to revisit this.
Yeah.
No, definitely. No, I just think it was one of those things where like it was always just something that we did and there was no like end date on it ever, you know?
Yeah, just, you know, never sort of had that thing of came across of, yeah, this is just normal, let's go keep going.
Yeah, this is, we've kind of come to terms with the normal chaos that doing this is, and I think we're starting to all just understand exactly what that all entails with the traveling and recording and just doing this as like a, I don't know, a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle.
It's heavy.
That's a deep.
That is deep. It's kind of a lifestyle.
No, it 100%
is.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the first thing when I'm thinking of, it's like, I'm going to do you guys this interview. It's like, it's the first thing I have to go with.
Oh, yeah.
Which is sort of that elephant in the room of, yeah, I have to think of that.
Yeah, it's been a long time doing this, especially too, like, we came out of playing really, really small bars in Kent, and to see what it is now is just kind of insane. I think Sunday is going to be a sort of a surreal moment because I remember when we were playing shows with like 15 and 20 people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or just like two drunk people.
Oh, yeah, no. Canton. Yeah.
Yeah. That was fun.
Columbus. One time we played to like six people there.
Lady, there's only so many times you can ask for a drum solo.
Drum solo. Yeah, dude.
I don't think she really
she
realized
was
it happened.
A great time.
Yeah. But, you know, it's all fine. She was entertained.
It's all for the fans, man.
I don't think she realized it happened, but you know what?
It's all cool. For the fans.
All power to her.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Thank God those days are over.
Yeah. Now it's just homeless people after shows.
And during.
During.
That's only when we travel.
Yeah. Well. No, remember that dude walked into that venue when we were loading in, like, behind us?
No, was I there
for
that?
It was in Akron. It was in Akron. That dude just, like, walked in and started talking.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Nah.
Yeah.
That seems interesting.
Yeah. Yeah, no.
It was just some guy. He's, like, walked in, and he was just, like, hanging out with us. Yeah. I'm like, you don't have a home, sir, do you? He's like, what? I was like, all right. Yeah. So
he's
hung out.
Literally just talking with us for a while,
like,
and then he left.
You want to grab a box? Help us load in, or
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, just whatever you do, don't drop it.
Yeah, just don't break anything. But yeah, he was nice.
Nice.
Yeah.
Are you guys excited, pumped in that for it?
I'm so ready for it. It's
are
insane.
You sort of afraid even?
No, I'm not really nervous. I think we've been working like on specifically this show for so long that now it's just like, all right, it's time to do it. Like, I'm so ready to just walk on stage. I just need to fast forward through the rest of this week.
Yeah. We got a pretty busy week prepared for us, getting all the preparations made for the show and everything.
Yeah. Oh, 100%.
Doing like pretty four rehearsals or something like that.
Oh, yeah. We're in crunch time now.
Yeah.
Crunch time. I like it. Because I'm good at that. Not really. So, I want to see anyone out there? Anyone alive out there that wants to chat in? I don't know if they will or not. Especially for the first night of opening up this of our lovely monthly week. Or, wow, I got that backwards. It sort of happens in that. So.
It's like way behind.
Here's a good one. Yeah, that's the opposite version.
Yeah.
But, let's say now, in another 10 years, where do you guys think you're going to be at?
The most popular musical act of all time? I think that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sounds
well on our way.
Something like that.
Somewhere along those lines.
That or dead. I don't know.
Oh, 10 years.
Wow.
10 years. I don't know. Well, here's the thing. It might be that we're dead and also...
Well, maybe in the Rock Hall.
We have to get to the 27 Club. Do you guys know what the 27 Club
is?
Of
course.
So 7 years is really the question. Seven years dead.
I'm older than both of you guys.
Okay.
So they didn't tell you would be in the Rock Hall?
Yeah.
Yeah. We're going to see, the thing is, you have to be around for like 20 years before you can get in the Rock Hall.
Okay.
So 10 years, right on the money.
Yeah.
But the serious answer is we have no idea.
Yeah, well, no.
We have no idea.
We don't, just figure we don't take care. A stab out there.
Yeah. We're just going to do the thing.
World just going to do a thing?
Yeah.
World tours?
Well, yeah. Maybe.
Things and stuff and that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Just
I like how that's
bigger
like
and
following.
Better. Yeah, no, that's
Things
should,
and stuff.
Yeah. That's really what this is. We've kind of just been riding the wave of it growing and growing and... We have so much random stuff that kind of drops on our plate sometimes, but it's fun. It really is.
It's fun?
Yeah.
We wouldn't be doing it if it wasn't.
I had to go and play with that, though.
Yeah.
I'd meet somebody evil deep down inside. So, guys have any other secret records or that coming out?
Secret records? Do we ever have a secret record?
I mean, we've got a decent amount of songs that we've
written. A bunch of demos, yeah.
We always just write. No secret records.
No silence.
No secret records
on that
we
right
could
now.
Say. No, I'm just kidding. No secret records.
But yeah, no, we've really been hitting the No Sleep, No Silence stuff hard. We head out this summer to play a bunch more shows. And just that was a big musical change for us. And I think we're all sort of still getting used to going out and playing those songs every night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're just going to, in terms of secret records, probably later.
Soon-ish, but later.
Yeah. And we're just going to keep the evolution going.
Yeah, pushing it more. I think No Sleep, No Silence for us was definitely the first time that we had found something that was, like, entirely unique to us. And the more we're writing now, too, I think we're starting to push ourselves even more and more out of that comfort zone, too.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I feel like it's... If we were going to record the songs that we wrote 4 months ago versus the songs we wrote a month ago, those would be
two totally different things.
So we're just going to keep writing, and eventually we're going to land on a
Somebody's
going
to have to cut us off and be like, you know, it's time to do this.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah.
Definitely. But, you know, always have to go in that whole thing of, even though we're sort of actually doing everything a little bit improper things and stuff and that and secret records and that. So I'm just sort of rolling with it, you know.
Yeah.
Hey, what, since you walked in the door, that's sort of been sort of that thing.
No, exactly. But so, yeah, and there's no secret records being worked on right now or anything.
It happens.
It will happen.
It will happen?
Now I just want to make a secret record. Cause yeah. I've never heard of one, but now I want to make one.
And mostly.
Then, and then never.
One Last Love Scene was our secret.
We do have a secret single, though. Nobody knows about it. If you can find it on the internet.
Good job.
Good for you.
Great job.
Most definitely.
Yeah, we're mostly focusing on the show coming up right now, and then we're scheduling a bunch of shows for the summer and fall.
Yeah.
That's our number one priority right now.
In a city near you.
Probably.
In a city near you, if you live in, like,
the northeast,
northeast,
midwest.
Yeah. Yeah. If you don't, then...
Then drive.
Yeah. All four of you probably live.
Near is pretty relative, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the biggest one coming?
Ooh. Oh, man.
Venue-wise.
Probably Cleveland.
Yeah.
I mean, the biggest show for us is probably going to be the local one.
Always. Yeah.
But during the summer, we really have no idea because we've never been to any of these places.
Yeah. Well, most of them, at least, yeah.
Oh, probably. Wait, what? Which ones?
I mean, like, most of the places we haven't, you know,
like,
played.
Besides, like, the Cleveland and...
Yeah.
Rochester?
Yeah, Rochester, yeah. Louisville, all that. Am I, like, slowly releasing all of our tour dates right now?
Yeah. Okay. It's probably not a good idea.
Whoa.
We have some...
Zucco.
Hate going.
Do we? What's going on?
Can you stop? You're hurting our feelings.
Oh, it's one guy being stupid.
We're somebody sensitive. Stupid.
Yeah, I think that's...
We're sensitive
I'm
musicians.
Sorry, man. We are.
And we need to be treated nicely. Oh, there's more.
Oh, no.
I literally have no idea what's going on.
No.
Ha ha.
Okay.
I actually got him.
I can't see anything right now.
So I'm being dumb. Especially because he just has his IP address banned for forever.
I don't know. He seemed nice.
We
should let him back.
What's going on. Anyway,
he brought us down, and now we're all gonna quit.
that was the line. Yeah, you know it's really.
And
well,
we're gonna hang up our guitars forever. Okay, go on.
No, you're
fine. No, he's going to have to hang up his computer for forever.
You know,
I actually beat him to the punch.
It's too bad.
I have no idea.
It's a shame.
Someone being stupid, you know, ragging on someone in chat, which I can ban IP addresses for forever. And coincidentally, him messaging again gave me that small moment to go and actually do that.
What if it was a her?
I don't know. Whoever.
Anyway,
that person.
Speaking of hanging up our guitars forever, we can play songs too. Like,
yeah.
If you guys want to.
Yeah. Yeah, we
could
do that. Yeah. Most definitely.
What do you want to play?
I was sort of going to almost point to that until he noticed that guy.
All right.
So I can do that.
Or girl.
Okay, what do we play? Ben?
Yeah. Yeah, Lionhearted.
Let's do it.
Chances breaking my knuckles, rebel stressed and hollow might. Grab the weapon strapped to your ankles. Boston wants a dirty fight. Link your chains and call out for action. Don't forget the fall tonight. Raise your fist out into the darkness. Boston wants a dirty fight. We'll be kings of the underground. We are the fire. We spark when we're united. As their cars ignite, show them a bulletproof alliance. Let's give them a dirty fight. City streets are swelling with sirens, but we're not the ones that hide. Raise your fist out into the darkness. Let's give them a dirty fight. We'll be kings of the underground. We are the fire. We spark when we're united. We are the bold. We are the sound, we are the lion hearted. dress in Harlem white. Grab a weapon strapped to your ankles. We all want a dirty fight. We are the fire. We spark when we're united. We are the bull.
I try to be wild, especially as Tim's messaging in. What's up, fellas?
Hey, Tim.
How's everything going over there?
Hi, Tim.
Hi, Tim. How are you doing, man?
Miss you. Tim is my neighbor, kind of. He used to be, I guess.
Kind of, sort of?
He used to be. I don't really live there. I don't know if he lives there still.
Yeah, I think so.
I live there during the summer.
Summer.
I'm going to tweet out your home address.
Yeah, I don't do that.
Then you're going to have... Hey, but you could always live up that you'll have huge mass of crowds of people not shouting your name outside your house.
I don't think anybody would do that. And if anybody did, it would just be my parents, and they'd be like, can you leave?
Yep.
Yeah.
He's still there.
Well, that's nice. Say hi to my parents.
It's kind of sad.
What's sad?
What's that saying to do you, or saying to yourself, having someone else to go and do it? I mean, seriously, just think of that.
Yeah. Wait, that's a fair point.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
I'm confused.
You're confused?
What he's saying is you're having someone else say hi to your parents for you.
No, I'm saying he should say hi.
I think that's how most people use the say hi to something, you know?
Yeah, like go say hi to them.
We have these things called... phone so you could send a text message.
Yeah. Okay, this is getting out of hand. I talk to my parents all the time. I said hi to them. I was there like 3 days ago.
I just felt like going that way, you know.
I am confused. I mean, I am confusion.
That's the whole mind behind the show.
It's just a blur of confusion and anxiety. And stuff and
things. Oh, a blur of confusion. That could be the name.
Blur of
Oh, yeah. The secret album.
I'm about to say, what about a secret record?
Bang, yeah, the secret record is going to be that.
For sure.
See, now you have to take these notes. I'm really good at coming up with names for things and stuff. Not really.
Yeah,
Don't worry, I'm not going to come after for a copyright or anything.
Yes, if you see Blur of Confusion. Come on.
Blur of Confusion.
I won't sue for copyright and stuff.
That sounds like something.
It's
like,
all new metal band, yeah.
I was about to say, that sounds like a prog rock
type
of...
Yeah, exactly.
Whatever. Yeah.
Cleveland, this one's up to you.
Nice, I give that. So, with everything going on, what you're going to be going and releasing here maybe in the short future, did you ever sort of see that when you first started about like 2 years ago going and happening? Did you see it with like maybe within the first 5 years, or you thought it was going to take longer?
Well, it took us five years before we actually put out our first like CD. So Ben and I were both so young when we both started like playing and chill. We were still kind of like learning our instruments at the time. So a lot of what we were doing was just like covers and, you know, stuff like that. Only Good Karma was actually part of the second set of songs that was really ever written by us. And, you know, I
got fired. What?
I'm not even sure. Like,
sorry.
What?
Nothing going on.
But yeah, I like, I never thought that it would be what it is now in some ways. Like, I never thought it would grow in the way that it did. I think for us, when we got all those radio spots in Europe and stuff like that, was sort of a weird thing for us.
Yeah.
Because that was sort of out of left field. Like, we had no idea that that was going to happen or was, you know.
And suddenly we had, like, hits on our website from, like,
everywhere.
England and
Russia.
Yeah.
And then
Russia.
We had that article in Jolt and Buzznet. And
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it was just, it was a weird period because it was the first time outside of, like, Ohio we were ever, like, recognized as for anything, really, you know what I mean? And then to have it just kind of take off from there. Like, we had a day in January, I got a thing from our distributor saying that we had, like, 400 streams and sales in Europe in 24 hours. I was like, that was kind of insane. Like,
big time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's definitely.
We've never been there before. I'd love to go.
To where?
Over in Europe.
Oh, yeah.
You'll have to pick out your, you know, English accent.
Yeah, UK be tight.
Yeah, that would be so good.
Just expensive.
Just very expensive.
Besides Tim firing or decreeing that you're all fired.
Yeah, that's why I'm still. What is
then
that?
Then rehired for triple negative pay.
I wouldn't worry about it too much, personally.
This blur.
That's his thing. He likes firing people
and then
even
hiring
though,
them back.
Yeah, that's triple negative pay.
That's nice. It seems like a Michael Scott move. I don't know why. I've been watching a lot of The Office, and it just seems like something Michael Scott would say. So that's that. So yeah.
Then now he wants to ask this question of, who would you guys want to open for, and why?
Oh, Ben, you first.
All right. I'd like to open for 21 Pilots because they're pretty local and
they're pretty local.
Yeah, they're fairly local.
You mean local as in like they came from Ohio, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Also,
I was about to say like.
Also, I think that they are really creative songwriters and it's just would be cool to work with them.
That's a good one. That'd probably be mine too.
Yeah.
Really?
If not them, then. I don't know, do you have an answer?
I mean, I'm kind of partial to, like, Blink-182, because that's sort of where this whole thing started from, but
like,
I feel like that'd be a totally different thing than, you know, that'd be a dream come true. If I could go up on tour with any band right now, it would probably be, Bad Sons would be rad.
Yeah.
Bad Sons would
be
awesome.
I don't really like them that much.
Oh, yeah.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Imagine 75 would be cool.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 100%. Well,
or Frank Iero.
Yeah. Anybody on Vagrant.
Yeah. But yeah, probably 21 Pilots for me, too. Just because they seem like cool guys and make really good music, and they're very...
That Ohio love. That,
yeah.
That's what we're going to call it. It's going to be us, them, the Black Keys, and Hawthorne Heights.
Yeah, they're still a thing, right?
They are, yeah. Yeah. I saw them in, what was it, October-ish?
And Reliant K. And Devil Wears Prada. They'll be the...
Is Devil... Oh, I did not know that.
They're from Dayton. They're so good. So
okay.
Good.
Yeah.
I like metal sometimes. So.
Since he sort of went there, and I was sort of saving this, let's say you guys are big guys. Who would you want to open, or who would you necessarily want to have open for yourself?
See, the only
are we talking locals or like larger people?
Anyone.
Oh, the only thing.
Your choice. You're the big dude.
Is like, if we could have whoever, like, I feel like having like somebody I really like Frank Iero, for example, have him open for us. I feel like that'd be disrespectful. Like he, to be like, hey, person who. Who inspired my music? Can you open for us? You'd be like, hell no.
That would be an odd phone call, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I don't know, man.
If I had to pick like a larger band that would like open for us, what larger band fits kind of in the same bracket as us? I know it's like a really weird mix of people, but
I don't really know. Because you can go one way with it, with, like, I don't know.
Lionheart and Back to Me are totally different from, like, Glasshouse and Wolves and all that stuff.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, okay. You had a lot to pick from, though.
Just give us a couple hours. Metro station for that.
Yeah, we'll write up the contract.
Is that cool?
It's okay, I got you covered.
You know what? I'd say the same people as we said before.
Yeah, basically. I wouldn't change it.
If they were okay with it, and then we would switch off headlining, opening, and then I'd feel okay.
Yeah. And we just try not to get shown up by the opening act. That's all.
Yeah.
No pressure, you know.
You don't want that happening.
No pressure at all.
But this is a hypothetical, so I'm going to say hypothetically we nailed it and everything went perfectly.
Yeah. But you never know. You could be in that circle.
Yeah, it's sort of a weird thing, too, because even, like, I remember seeing the dudes in, like, All Time Low playing with Fall Out Boy, and now they're kind of, like, in that spot where, I don't know, you go and you see, like, smaller bands, like, opening up for them, and, like, yeah, that's sort of the dream situation, so, yeah.
Yeah.
You get to the point where you just, then you're that person, you know?
That'd be good. That'd be good.
Then it leads into my thing of within the next 2 years, where do you want to be touring at?
I would say
all over the U.S.
Yeah, nationally.
Europe would be awesome because
just Canada. Sorry,
exclusively.
Yeah. Exclusively,
but just the tundra just maple part syrup. Of Canada,
Northern Canada, Southern.
There's like two people at every show. The bartender and the door guy.
let's stick to that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I feel like 2 years, national tour.
I'd love to go to the UK and do Europe.
We were actually talking about that in the car right here.
Yeah.
Get a church van. That's the best church way to do it. A church van. Because...
Church bus.
Yeah, church bus. It's big enough. You can fit people and there's bunks and benches you can lay down. You can drive across the country in that.
For sure.
Except Europe. You can't necessarily drive across with that.
Put flotation devices on the van and a solar-powered engine. Take that sucker across the Atlantic.
I could see you guys more using going over there. You see a double-decker.
That'd be fun.
Oh, hold up.
We were talking.
That's a great idea.
Remember we were going to have before the street lights on
before
top.
Before the street lights on top. Hold up, yeah, we had that idea. I remember that. We would never be able to go under a bridge. Huh. They literally limit. Get off and on every single exit.
Whatever.
That would be funny, though.
That'd be very funny. It
would make you very unique, though.
Yeah.
Well, I feel like you could do, like... Okay, yeah, that's just getting into a whole other thing. You could have, like... The upstairs be like super rad, just like party bus style, you know. So downstairs bunks.
Everyone
bunks, TV.
It's quiet floor.
Yeah.
And study floor on the bottom, like a library.
Yeah.
And the top one is
fourth floor, Kent State.
The fourth floor, there's no. It's a library. People are just blaring music, just jumping over tables, and I'm about to go there actually. So.
Oh God. That could be either good or bad.
It's good. It's controlled.
Controlled
chaos.
Controlled
chaos.
That's
what this band is, too. It's just like trying to get everybody in the same spot at the same time is just insane.
It sort of leads with my next thing in that. So, I'll sort of go this. I had to go and do my evil little hand gestures in that.
I'm nervous.
So, what was the most hardest thing over the past 10 years?
Making the first record. Like...
Can we talk about All Time Low?
I was just about to say, I felt like the same thing just came to all of our minds, but we just had a judgment call to make. Do we talk about it? Well, I would say that...
Also, there's four people listening, so we're fine.
You know what? I'm going to say, like, bottom line is we were working on some songs with Ryan Dawson from All Time Low, and... There was an emergency that came up for him, so we are not doing that. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I mean, our whole, like, cycle for recording, it was just got super thrown off,
we got
so.
Goofed. We were down there, we drove all the way down there, and it was, we had one of the best days in the studio.
Oh, yeah, such a good day in the studio.
Great day, great guy, good music being made, good, good talks.
Yeah,
good
for beer. Sure.
Just always good.
And then to have that happen was just like, oh man,
like
just the life gets sucked out of you.
Yeah. We're so close.
Yeah, I was like, so close. We're 3 days into Nashville, and then to have to like come home.
Yeah.
It was just like.
But I mean, like.
It's the ultimate walk of shame.
Yeah, no, for sure. That definitely threw us off, but I feel like we've got a plan now, and we're just moving on past that. We're going to make an even tighter.
Yeah.
New set of songs.
You just got to, like, take advantage
of. When we hit the studio next.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's all about making the most out of the stuff that just doesn't work out, I guess.
Yeah.
But, I mean. A lot of what we do is super, like, on the fly. Not really, like, on the fly, but a lot of what we do is you can't really plan out that far ahead of time because stuff always happens and comes up. So you just got to run with it. You got to be flexible.
That's true. Make the best of what you can.
Oh, yeah.
I definitely feel that. So you guys feel like another song?
Let's do it.
Besides afterwards, what, do the whole promotion thing.
This one's called Hiding from the Wolves. Let's do it.
Crime that we chase needs another disguise. And if we go down, let me go down together. If we get caught, boss can't hold us forever. There's something dark in the sky and it's getting worse. And all your words stain my thoughts like blood on my shirt. And if we go down, then we go down together. And if we break our bones, we're meant for the better. Oh no, this is the way it goes. Oh no, when we go down, we'll show no.
Gold in our hands. One gets gold.
actually get it right, of being on time than a few seconds delayed.
Right. That was perfect. That was perfect.
Sort of been like that for like the past week. They're on it, sometimes they're a few seconds off. Yeah, those people.
I appreciate it, though.
Tim's wondering, one place you could play, where would it be?
Ooh, I would love to do the Metro in Chicago.
Yeah, that sounds pretty cool. I hear Madison Square Garden is a pretty cool place.
That's great, yeah.
Wembley.
Yeah.
Wembley's... Goodness.
Well, now he sort of switched it around. That you haven't played yet.
Wembley.
Yeah.
That's true.
The O2.
Basically, yeah, anywhere. Chicago is a really cool city. So anywhere, yeah, Chicago, New York, or London.
London.
London's in London, right? Yeah. Probably. I don't know. I'm American. I'm fucking stupid, so. So, yeah.
You know the funny thing? This is the most that I ever heard you talk.
Today?
Really, sort of past once. He sort of, you know, was a little more quieter.
Who? I never shut up.
Every once in a while, like last year, last April, he was sort of quiet. I sort of remember that.
I don't know, man.
A little
bit.
Know.
I don't know.
The bad thing is I can't actually pull up that on this computer.
I'm just so used to being around you, and it's just like...
Yeah.
Well, hold up. Pre-coffee, Ian does not talk.
Oh, that's not
that
even
is,
human.
That is, you don't... Yeah, like,
that's not a human.
Yeah, once you get a little bit of coffee in Ian, he's good to go for the day.
Yeah, before that, don't...
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Oh. Wait, I'm not going to be trustworthy. I need to be chill about it.
Sir, what?
Oh, Tim, you're so silly.
I know, that's a very silly sort of weird pun line.
He's a goofball.
Did we just get a chill joke? Is that what it
yeah.
was?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So if I'm not going to be going to be trusty security, I'm going to...
Let's talk about chill jokes for a second. Because I have heard literally hundreds... Probably of chill jokes throughout my life,
and it gets funnier every time.
It does,
and never gets old. Funnier. And everyone thinks they're the first person to say "chill" as like a pun.
You know, what's weird is we really didn't get that early on because we had the band name Chill before people actually said that as like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it turned out pretty well though.
Yeah.
Except for the puns. I'm just kidding.
It was, we actually named the band Chill for subliminal marketing.
Yeah.
Well, so anytime you're talking to your friends, yeah.
It's okay, Tim. We love you.
Yeah. I always wanted to ask that, but I wasn't sure about that. That sort of that redundant thing that happens about jokes.
Everywhere we go.
Yeah.
And they're always like, haha, chill.
The three of us just
and we're
like,
yeah, I'm gonna punch you in the head. Is that what you want?
That will get there.
No, but we're just like, oh, good one. How'd you think of that?
But secretly, you just want to take them out behind the, you know, place.
I actually, maybe this is controversial for us, but I kind of like it when people do that. It's like, I don't know.
It brings everybody together.
It brings people together.
Mostly
it's just that, I don't know, for just a moment, they get to feel like, oh, I did something with the band thing, you know?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
They did something clever.
And, it makes them feel happy. Yeah. And I'm really excited to see what Tim's about to say.
I figured out what CHILL stands for.
I don't think you did.
Hold one time.
So, do you guys have any horrible jokes about what it stands for?
We've had attempts before.
I told people that CHILL, when there was four of us, it's the first initials of all of our names. And they're like, oh, okay.
They just don't even think about it.
I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, because B doesn't fit in there.
I don't think any of them besides me.
Yeah.
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 In the children hate idiot landlords.
I don't know, man.
That was the first time someone actually got the correct version.
You got it right.
I don't know how you cracked the code, Tim.
He's been going through all of our... It's every letter of the first tweet that we've sent out every 3 months for the last...
That would be wild.
No, it was in the fine print on every single album or EP.
I think so. When we signed our contract, that's what it was under. Yeah,
I was in the fine print on the first album.
You were.
In the very bottom corner, it says assisted by Ian Minnick. And then you get your, you know, magnifier, your monocle, and you read it.
We could really pull that out.
Yeah.
I still got those.
That's far.
Yeah, it's either up there or here. One of the places.
Yeah, it was Bixel and you.
Miss Bixel.
Isaac? Yeah. Dude, I haven't seen him.
Did anyone ever tell you something that was completely outrageous? Like, they even have one of those letters in there?
I don't really remember. Yeah.
You just want to start.
They don't really make sense like 99% of the time.
I don't know if anybody's ever asked about.
I've had people definitely ask that before. Yeah.
Take a guess at it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We should make something up someday.
That'd be funny.
Secretly?
Yeah. You change the storyline.
Tell no one?
Yeah, secretly, you say it's that, you know, fine line cult thing.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
See, you're coming out with all these good secret things.
I feel like this is a good brainstorming session. The double decker bus. I'm back on that idea now.
A secret record that we won't.
Secret record.
Well, actually, what if we just don't make a record and tell people we do?
It's a very secret record. Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty good. So we have a secret record. We just made it.
Yeah. Comes out today.
Yeah, it comes out today. It only lasts for like 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Hurry up to iTunes and whatever. Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
See, if you ever need help, I come up with these weird things. Just give me, you know.
He's a very expensive consultant.
Yeah, I'm very expensive.
It's worth it, though.
Yeah.
Every penny.
Because it'll be really out there. Completely outrageous, like the ideas of Man and Kyle. I mean, oh my god. I'm not going to go and insult their love life.
Anyway,
and yet the blur. I love him. Ben gets weirded out. He just goes anyway.
Anyway, well,
the blur continues. I want to dive deeper into this blur. Let's talk about Matt and Kyle.
No, let's not. Let's talk more about.
I have no idea.
Kyle, you probably seen him here before. Skinny kid, glasses, sort of stuttered. No.
So
I know, Matt, you have absolutely no clue of. So.
So, anyway, so, yeah.
Anyway, did I ever ask you, Ben, did you ever have a name for the cajon?
I'm sorry? A name what?
Yeah, name for it.
Did you ever name your...
No, but I had a bass named Susan, you know, as is only appropriate. I don't name my drum sets, though.
I only had three guitars that were named. I don't do that, really.
I'm a 20-year-old man, so I don't name any. Just kidding.
No, that's not really our thing. Oh, that's right.
No, I didn't.
That's sort of that one cajon thing, you know.
Is it a cajon thing?
This?
Every once in a while.
I know it's a cajon.
I don't know. I don't know, man. This is just like a wooden box, essentially. I don't feel like it deserves a name.
It might
be controversial to say that, but this box is not a person. So it's just...
It is, in fact, a noun.
As opposed to my bass. Yeah. Just earned that right through many trials, tribulations.
I like it. Because that's sort of my whole thing whenever I interview people, I ask that. After I stumbled across one person that named it, it ended up in an argument about an Irish box. Long story there.
Yeah. Do you
want to
play my song?
Do you want to play hooks?
Yeah. I can play hooks.
Ooh.
Okay.
All right.
And just do like acoustic guitar. And...
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
Yeah, sure.
Just because I like... curveballs.
No Cajon?
I mean, you could, but it's going to be...
Yeah, I know what you're saying. This one's impromptu.
What?
It's off the Secret 2-Minute album.
Yeah, actually, it's...
Yeah, you can find the Secret album on iTunes.
For 2 minutes.
It's called No Sleep, No Silence. We're chill with 1L.
Right there. Regular key? Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Tell me when. Cool. This one's called Hooks. It's crazy.
I try a car already parked outside, and I locked on the wretched center in my sight. The scent of the sweat stained your skin and stole your breath. I'm sinking by your second face, but you dug your hooks at me, and as I tell them out of play, oh I try to tear free. I crash for the ditch to keep. Who would have guessed I left the mess your bedroom seen? The scent of his sweat stained your skin and stole your breath. Oh, I try. Darker shades. I'm sinking by your second face. But you dug your hooks at me, and as I tell them out of play, oh I try.
Probably 10. No, I don't know who that is. Where did the name actually come from in the first place? I know you probably said that at some point in time.
You know, it's honestly been so long that I have no idea where, like, chill actually came from. But it had been around since before we were even, like, really playing. We kind of, like, had the name. Again, this was over 10 years ago. So I'm really not sure where chill actually came from. It's just always been a thing for us. I mean, we played our first show with it in 2007. And
yeah.
And we were young, though. 10, 11 years old, so.
Yeah, I don't think we really thought it through too much. It's just like, chill sounds cool. Yeah. Two L's? Maybe not. Yeah. Who needs the other one?
Who needs the other one? We're very lean operation.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I wasn't there.
It was someplace.
I was, I don't know where it was. It was in Paintsville.
Paintsville.
Yeah. At Riverside.
Yeah, it was at Riverside.
Sixth grade.
I was in sixth grade. It was 10.
Yeah.
I had it. No, I'm not going to actually go there.
Just go for it, man.
No.
It's your show.
Alright. Oh, no, I'm not going to go there. I'm not sure where I was going to go there on, though.
I don't know either.
Maybe.
I don't know.
Besides, where do they check out your stuff at?
You can check us out at chillrockband.com and also on iTunes, Spotify, just about anywhere that you get your music. You can find us at Chill and Chills with 1L.
Funny thing is, first time I ever had to put your guys' name into anything, I actually spelled it with one.
Oh, nice.
Really?
On purpose or on accident? Or
I don't know. I wasn't thinking at the time.
That's good.
I just heard that it's like, start typing it in, then someone starts spelling. It's like, I already have that.
That's good.
Nice. We intentionally did that.
Yeah.
Like me intentionally doing that for I don't know what reason. Because you would normally think two L's.
Yeah, that's fair.
It's a really messed up thing. Because I never knew about it until it was like Tim or somebody who's come and said, hey, well, we have this, or these guys coming. It's like, okay. And it's like, yeah. So we have to see.
Yeah.
Because you gotta go. Right?
Yeah. That's pretty.
No. Good time.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, thanks for having us on and hanging out and everything.
Yep.
Yeah.
Just a reminder to everybody, April 9th, this Sunday,
yeah,
we are doing our 10-year show. Yeah. And then you can expect to hear a lot more from us after that.
Yeah. Again, online pre-sale, like for the cheaper tickets, ends tonight at midnight on our website, chillrockband.com/shop. And we're stoked to see everybody out on Sunday.
Yeah, same. Ditto.
And whatever during the summer and at the different places and things and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. That'll all slowly get announced after, this 10-year show.
Very cool.
Yeah. For sure.
Bad thing is I forgot the name of whatever I had the show.
I think we're gonna stick with Blair of Confusion.
Yeah, Blair of Confusion. That's fair. We renamed it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's okay. It just took on its own form.
That's how confusing it is. The show name changes from beginning to end, so you never know.
Or it's just like because it's a Monday night.
That'd be like the most hipster band ever, though. Like, they never play a show.
They're doing Parks and Rec.
Wait, really?
They ended with Rat Mouse.
Oh, yeah. Mouse no, Rat. I know. He Mouse changed, Rat. Like, all the time. Yeah, Mouse Rat.
Yeah, he changed his name, like, 100 times.
Yeah, but I feel like if you never played a show under the same name, that would just be, like, a super, like... Wild.
So
like, only the cool people know who they are.
Well, think about doing that. There's a new idea.
I'm just going to keep adding on L's every show.
Chill with 90.
90 L's at the end of the
year. You're getting really out there.
Somebody, for every L we take, we put one on. So so we're going to need to add a few L's.
We're going to need to add.
No. Every 1,000 likes, you add one on. It's a good marketing tool.
That's fair.
That's fair, yeah.
We'll do that.
Every 1,000 likes you get on your page, you'll add an L.
We'll start doing that. That's pretty good.
I just
we'll start handing them out.
Maybe when we hit 5 L's, it should, like, tally mark and go across.
I like it.
Whoa. Next level.
Yeah. New t-shirt design.
Some crazy shit.
Far and out there.
If only we did that for our 5-year.
Yeah. That would have been cool, actually. Not too late now.
We'll wait for a 20 year.
15, we'll just do 15.
Yeah, our 5-year would have been like the release of our first album.
First CD was.
It would have been like our first CD release plus our 5-year anniversary show. Yeah. That would have been a little strange, in my opinion.
Oh, dude, I missed the neon hair and the.
No, you don't.
Oh, those were the days.
Keep wishing. It'll come. It'll come back in fashion.
Oh, God.
Maybe with the double-decker bus.
That's still cool. I don't think that's ever going to go away.
No, it won't. Most definitely won't. But it's been a pleasure, guys.
Awesome. Thank you so much, man.
Thank you.
Man.
And thank you for coming.
It's always fun.
Because our random confusion and other different ideas that we come up in the middle of this.
That's what we seek out. So, yeah.
We're really good at that here.